Hello, welcome back again into my channel. So, there was a question from one of my viewer on my one of my video. It's about the saving from element data into custom post type in Bricks Builder. So he asked one of his fields is an image. The image is being uploaded to his site, but the image is not showing on the custom post type. Probably. That's because the image is not attached to the post. So I will show you how to do that, and then I will show you. You can customize your form, not just like the default Bricks field, but you can extend it. You can have a text editor by using a JavaScript library called Trumbo YG, I think. I suppose I don't know how to pronounce it. And then you can have you can extend another input field, so you can create your tag, which is nice. So there's something like this. Is similar with the how you create about how you input the tag in the post editor in the WordPress itself. And of course, I will show you how to update a custom meta field if you have any. So let's start, shall we? Let's talk about what should I explain for the first step. Okay, let's do this. Let's delete this. The first is we're gonna create a form, so it's not special. You can just like add your form element, and then let's delete all first. Let's add a field for a post title. Let's use a text type and change the label to like post title. Placeholder change to, yeah, you can, this is optional. And I'm gonna use the name as a post title. It's better than to use the field ID. And second is the post title and post content. Use the text area, or you can use the text input field, it doesn't matter. Let's name it post content. Name the add attribute name post content. Yep. And what's next? A category, sure. We can use select type, change it to like post category. Placeholder, yes. The name, let's use post category. And what's next? The tag, sure. For the tag, use the text field. Title label is post text, yeah, because it can have many tags. The name is post text name, yep. Nice. And then what's next? Post category, post tag, image. Okay, so we're gonna set this field into our thumbnail or feature image of the post. So use the files name post, let's say post image, and name attribute post image. Choose file, yeah, max file. You can define this. Save file, yes, in media library. Allowed file format is JPEG or separate by comma, JPEG or a PNG, or maybe you wanna put some WEBP, And what's next? Image, dan title, content, category, tag, image. Oh yeah, if you have a like, custom field, we will try to update that. So let's say label is your custom field, placeholder same name, post field, post my field. Okay, so let's name it like that. Yep, I think that's all. Yes, okay. Let's see on the front end first. Post title, post content. The post category is doesn't display because we don't set the option. Okay, post tag, choose file, and custom field, and the button send. Okay, so let's go to our snippet. The first thing is you're gonna create a function to populate or to get and to get the category term. So let's say okay, let's see. I will delete this first. You go to snippet plugin, to your snippet plugin, or you can use the function file of your team child folder. But in this example, I'm using a code snippet plugin. I'm not sure which plugin is this. I think that's this called code snippet. Code snippets, yep. So I will edit this one. You can rename it like form to CPT functionality, whatever. Okay, so let's say first. Okay, let's I already have the function. So I will just copy paste to make this faster. Okay, so basically this function will get the term of the taxonomy. The default taxonomy for the post is category, as you can see here on the slug. You can see the taxonomy equal category. If you have like another custom taxonomy, you can just put the slug here and fill it with the name. Okay, and upload. Okay, I will share the link for this code because I found this on the Brix forum, but I forget to make note of the source. But I will put it on the my video description. This is not, this one is not. Okay, and we're gonna sanitize the code so it can run by the Brix. I'm using this, so this function name. Let's save first. Okay, so what I need to do is just like copy the function name into the Brix form, which is the post category. So basically just like echo display terms, something like this. Let's save and let's see on the front end. Okay, you see there is like 1, 2, 3, 4 category. Is that right? Let's see. Cat A, cat B, cat C, uncategorized. It's Azan here, so please bear with it. Okay, and then what should I do next? Let's prepare the JavaScript for the text editor here for the post content. I'm using this library. So let's see. I will go. Okay, so the first thing is enqueue the file, the JavaScript file and the CSS file which is required. Okay, so the first, this is the okay, so this is the Tranboy. Okay, so I need to use the same name. Not need to, but I think yeah, I have to use that the same with the name of the library. So this will be enqueue or load the CSS file. This is from the external file. It's better to you download it and then you upload it into your server. Maybe inside your team child folder or something. And this is the script for the Trumbo. Let's call it Trumbo because the Trumbo YG is really hard to pronounce. Okay, and if you take a look at the Trumbo requirement, it requires the jQuery. So you need to enqueue that too. Here, so this is the script, the code to load the jQuery. You don't have to specify the URL of the jQuery because the WordPress itself already has the jQuery. So you only need to load it by using this code, and then put the array of the Trumbo JavaScript. Put the jQuery into the array here. And then for the Tagify, I will explain it later because this will require to do some tagging in the input field. Okay, let's focus on the Trumbo first, on the text editor first. Okay, let's change. Let's see on the front end first to see whether our library is loaded or no. Let's see on the footer, I think, yeah, this one, as you can see. This one is the JavaScript file and the CSS on the head. So it's Trumbo here.
So okay, that's already loaded.
Then to be able to initialize the script, we need to create a custom script, which is this. So this is the element, the target element. This is our text area, and then this to initialize the Trumbo. You can just explore the option which it provide by visiting their documentation or their website. Its website, sorry. I will put the link below on the description below. So let's just copy this, and we're gonna add some custom script.
I'm gonna add some custom script and put it on the footer.
Like function. Okay.
Nah. let's copy paste the already existing code. Here's one. Okay.
Let's rename it and enqueue the form. Let's say form JS. Form lib library JS or something like this. Yep. And custom form. Okay, so this is the this will be so this code inside this function will be responsible to like the custom script for initialize the library. Which one is that? Okay, this one. And don't forget to change the priority. So the custom script here will be loaded after the library. Okay. So let's just I will delete this first. So let's take a look at the demo and at the documentation. I'm just gonna copy this and paste it here and change this to target the element. So let's go to our form element and see the name. So we're gonna target the text area with the attribute name post content. So like this.
Wait.
text area
and
put the attribute name, and then the value of the attribute postNet. Yep, that's right, I think. Let's save change and let's see how the result. Yep. Now our editor, our text edit, what you see is what you see, what you get. I cannot spell. It's what you see is what you get, something like this. And that's really good. Yeah, this is quite nice. Not complex. Not many feature, but I think this is enough for the front end only. We don't need. I don't have to. Like most of us, for the front end form to save as a post, we don't need to actually have many feature. Alright, so the past category done, the text area done. So let's move to the text. I'm gonna use the Tagify here. It's this really cool library script. So let's go back to our snippet. I already enqueue the style and the script which is required, and I need to add a new script to initialize the let's put below here to initialize the apa namanya, the Tagify, the field of the Tagify. So let's see, input mtag. Yeah, it's same actually. So let's just copy this, almost same, yeah, almost identical. Change the text area, change the target element to the actual element here. So the input tag with the attribute name and the attribute value is post tag. So the input element, input tag with the name attribute and the value is post tag. Change this
into Tagify, I think. New Tagify. Wait, I'm confused. Wait, sorry. No.
I think something like this. Tagify. Probably.
Let's take a look.
Probably.
Yeah, probably.
Okay. Yeah, not that one. Tagify is not a function, okay. Alright, so let's take a look at this. How they do it. Okay, so var Tagify, new Tagify. Okay, so we create a variable for the target element. Okay, so we create a variable. So like var tags,
something like this.
Var tags, okay, and then let's see, new Tagify. Okay, so I don't need this new Tagify. Alright, new Tagify, and then put the variable to this, I think this one. Let's save change. Let's see the front end. Now it's an error. Oh yeah, forget this one. Sorry, I was wrong. Oh, I think it will not work because they said that new Tagify input name post tag.
New Tagify.
I should not use the apa namanya itu single apa ya, semicolon, what's that, what's the name of this thing like this. Alright, so let's reload it. I think that will error again. What the hell? Tagify text input name post tag. Input yes name post tag.
New tagify.
New tagify. Why is not work? Why? Name. Text. New
tagify.
Tagify.
Ah.
Wait. So this is actually the code which is working. New tagify input.
Yeah.
Okay, let's take a look at here. Why this is working? This not. I'm not sure. So like for text input name same. Why? Okay.
All right, so let's save change and let's see.
I think this will work. There is no console error here. Oh, wah. Oh, not that. this one. Yeah, you see, it's working now. Yep. Okay, let's move to the we're gonna create a function to save the post as to save the form data into a post. So let's take a look at here. Actually, the Bix Builder website provide the sample, so you can use
this one. I probably.
Okay, so maybe this is the similar one to mine.
Alright, I will just copy and paste the working code, and I can just make a little
review about the code. Okay, so the add action custom action here, we're gonna add some custom action into the form. So let's save. Let's reload it. So the form on the action add a custom. Okay, and then this is the name of the function. The function to save the post, and this is from the bricks, I believe. Yes, so this one, and it will get the form setting, form fields, and form field file. So for the file, it has a specific or it has a like own code to get the data from the file, something like the URL. Something like that. Let's give validation form ID is not tegoyote. Okay, so the form ID is okay. So let's take a look at our form ID. Go to the form element, and you can see above here, you can just like copy the ID of the form. Change this, okay. And we're gonna set the, so this is the with the form field post title, it will get the data from the field which has name post title. Let's see. So this field, the name of this field is the attribute name is a post title. So actually, we can use like this. Using is set a pet name like post name or post title. Post title. Get oops. It will get the post title, and let's put the content on the second. So post title variable will get the form field of this. So I'm gonna change this to my content field name. So this is the name of the text area. Post content, but I think it's better to have like I will put here for temporary. Use this and just replace this and change this to post content. Get the post content. Get the category. We can use that. I think post category let's make sure post category name of the field is post category, yes, and then post tag. So actually, we because the when you see here, which one? Yeah, I think I saw like the output of the value which we create, the tag value we create is should be. Apa namanya, it's on the JSON format here and not array. I think this is JSON or array, I'm not sure, but yeah, the format is something like this. So we need to decode that. So apa namanya, later the WordPress will accept the value of the decoding result or something like that. So post tags, post tag, get tags, get category. Let's see. Let's make sure to have the name, the right name. Which one is that? Name post tags. Name post tag. Yep. And then okay. So this is for like post custom field. Sorry, I forget which. Okay, so the field name post my field. Okay, so we are gonna get the value of this input field and then save as our post meta field or post custom meta field, something like that. Post my field, post my field. Okay, post my field, post my field, get meta field, post, get post my field. All right, now we need to define the current ID. So if the user is logged in and then he submit the form, the post will be assigned to his, not to administrator or not to other user, but it will assign to his as his post, something like that. And this is the validation, I will not cover this because it will take too long and I don't really understand about this. I do apologize. But here, the post category ID, this function will apa namanya? The value which we selected from this apa namanya option from this select type field, it will save it will convert to the term ID. So because we need it later, okay. And as you can see here, there is an array which we get the data from here, it will be saved as this apa namanya is as this argument or parameter, something like that. You can just set your post type to your custom post type or to your post. So I will set it as post. Post title, this is for this security, I think, web strip alt tag. Post content, it will get the post content. The post status, you can change it to draft, pending, or something like that. Post type, okay. It already defined on the first, so I just need to delete it. The post category, okay, it will get the ID of the term from this. Okay, the post author, the current user ID, okay, see. Which one is the current user ID function? Okay, this one. And here, this function is to check and the process the image which is uploaded through the form. So this file, because the apa namanya the data we get is something, the structure data we get from the file is array, something like this. And this is the URL and this type. So we get the URL from the file and then set it as the feature image using set post thumbnail, this one. And then for the tag, like I say, the value which is saved from the tagify here is we need to decode it, and then apa namanya set it using web WP set post tags, okay. And for the post meta, for the custom field, using update post meta, and this is the post field flag. So let's say let's try add one custom field. Go to preference, I think. Oh yeah, it's there. Okay, this one, yeah. So let's enter new. Let's say my field. Add custom field. Okay, so just copy this into the here. My field, right? I think I change one of my name to name of the variable. Empty state. Oh, this one. Okay. Post JSON. Okay. Post category name. Yep. Post content, post title. Yeah, I think it's done. Let's say let's save change and let's test it. This is post title. Let's see. Okay, I have only one post, and let's add some content. Lorem ipsum agolorong. Agorolong, and then let's just copy this, okay, and let's add paragraph here. Oh, too much. and then add some list here. Just basic text. Let's add bold here and maybe some italic here. Yep. Set post category to like category B, post tag to like new tag B, new tag C, and let's choose the image here. I will use this one. I'm not sure which image is this, but yeah, whatever. Custom field to like this is my meta field. Okay, so let's send it and let's hope there is nothing error comes up. Okay, so it said it's success, but let's take a look. No, it doesn't save. What's the problem? Let's see. Post title, post category, post my field. Let's see. Wait. Oh yeah, I think I need to save it first because I already before I add a custom action. Let's see. Let's test first. Okay, let's test. This is like random. All right. It's not really work. Maybe I have something like post type post, post title, post content, post status publish, current user ID. Let's see the form ID. I curious. No, it's same. And function display name, set post. Post ID. Let's see, post. Oh, here, this one. It post my field, not post my field. It's better to have like error validation, but I will not. I don't have the code right now. Post text JSON. Post text JSON. Okay. Oh no, but it's right like this. Post my field. Post content. Post category name. Oh, this one. It's not bad, but it's post. Post tag, post my field, post title, I think this is right. So let's take a look at here. And I will open my error log. Maybe there is some catch. So let's delete first. Okay, let's send. No, still no. Let's see why it's not work yet. Category is there, respond terms okay. Yeah, this is okay. Add action.
Wait. Add action.
Is there any error? Okay, there is error. Attempt to read property term ID on boolean, okay, on line 74. Let's see. Post category ID. Get category. Post category name. No. Post category. Post category. Post category name. Term ID. Get category by slug. Post category name. Let's see. Post category, yes, that's right. So this is the category name. It will convert to term ID. Attempt to read property term ID on bool. Let's see. Category ID. Post category ID array. Post category ID.
Let's see what's wrong. Array post category ID.
Post category name. Term ID. Array post category ID now. That's right. Maybe there is something wrong with this. I will use this. Let's say I will use this post category. So let's use this code form field. This is the ID of the script ID of the form field category. So let's take a look at here. Oh no, I think I can use this maybe.
Form field take
it. Yep.
Huh.
Yep, I think. Something like this. Let's save it and let's delete this log. Okay. Category post tag. Okay, let's save and see. Yep. I think I should fill all. Okay. Alright, let's see. The title is there, the content is there, the post meta is there,
and the category is there, the tag is there, the feature image is not set up.
That's really weird. Let's see. This one I forget to change this name, this form field file ID. It's ID or name? I'm not really sure, but let's take a look at here. The name is post image. I need to change that to post image. Yep, I think this is cool. Let's save the change and let's add new. Okay. Lorem ipsum. Okay. All right. No. Okay, so like one paragraph. So this will be a bold. This will be a italic. This will be a list. Don't use italic, okay. And this will be a, yeah, I think that's enough. The post category will set to category C. The post tag is lorem ipsum. Lorem ipsum 2, okay, etc. etc. Choose file. Let's choose this one. Custom field. This is meta lorem ipsum. Let's send. Let's hope there is no. No such file on directory. File it to open stream. Alright, that's interesting. Okay, let's see this one. Okay, so this is the post content. This is.
Nah. The feature image is set.
Lorem ipsum meta field is set. The tag is set. The category is set. The author is set because it's me. This is the list. This is the italic, this is the bold. Let's see on the code editor, let's see code editor, style, strong, span, background color. UL, yeah, the tag, you need to like work on the tag too, on the HTML tag, which come apa namanya, I'm not sure this is from, I think because the copy paste or something like that, I'm not sure, I have to, I will not check it right now, but so far it's work, but I'm not sure why there is like error. Xnof touch file and directory on this one, it said. Yeah, you can like find the solution of yourself. If I found any solution, I will of course to tell you later. So I think that's good enough. I believe there is no any other issue, yeah. Yep, as you can see here, there is no any other issue. So I think this is good enough for now. This is just like the basic idea. You can just extend it for yourself. And this video is took a long, like actually like 45, 46 minutes. But anyway, thank you for watching. And thank you. See you. Bye bye. On the next video, happy coding, guys.